Hey guys, thanks for joining me again. My name's Oliver Shillito, and welcome to my channel. So, today, God, that sounded robotic. Sorry about that, it's been a while. Anyway, today, I am looking at Black Salt Audio Silencer. Now, I've seen a lot of people advertising this plugin recently. The ultimate drum debleeder and all that kind of thing. Now, we're going to look at today, is it good, for one? Two, is it bullshit? Three, do you need it? And four, you probably already got a plugin that does what it does. I'm going to include a free preset for you down below in the description as well, so stick around till the end of the video to find out what the preset does, but it's there if you want it. Okay, cool. So, into Pro Tools. Alright, so today we are looking at a drum track that's part of a wider project, but we're going to focus on the drums today. Now, this is Silencer, and it's got a pretty simple interface. You can control the amount of debleeding it does, the amount of reduction, the length. Let me just disable this and we'll listen to just the kick. Now, as you can hear, there is quite a lot of snare. You can hear a bit of cymbal in the background. Let's turn it on and hear what it does. Pretty good. Let's try it on the snare. Here's with it off. And on. Not bad. You can shorten the length of this significantly if you want it to be really tight. Cool. Let's change it. Let's put it on extreme settings and see what it does. Makes everything sound anemic, as expected. Never use plugins at full tilt, they always sound bad. The toms are the most, I think, stark example of what this does, so let's listen to them again without. And if we put Silencer in, pretty good. All right. So, kick, snare and toms. Let's have a quick listen to them all in together. Well, first of all, let's go without. Nice. And in. Now, for any eagle-eyed viewers out there, you will have just noticed I didn't enable Silencer. Instead, I enabled Slate Trigger. Do you really need Silencer? Let me show you what Trigger can do. There's a gate feature in Trigger. Let's look at the toms because they're the starkest example of bleed. If we open up Trigger, the trick to this is to put the mix on zero. If you turn the mix up, it's going to try to blend in whatever sample you may have selected. If you turn mix down, this does nothing. However, the gate feature still works. So, without trigger, and now if we put trigger back in, oh look, that interface looks incredibly similar. And again, you've got the exact same feature set, the attack time of it, the hold time, the release time. So we can put the release up, we can turn it down, make it a little tighter. You can make it really short if you want. Which are basically just going to make MIDI spikes, if you will, or we can turn it right up. Now, obviously, this is going to control the amount of time in which the gate actually holds before letting go. So it'll control the amount of after sound, afterthought you get, if you will. So if you want your toms to be a bit more sustaining, you can turn the release up a little bit and just let the transient hit and then the sustain of the tom. Or if you want your toms to be tighter sounding, just bunch it up a little bit so it cuts them. And it cuts them in a really natural sounding way. It's not like a light switch, it kind of tails off. So it's quite a good way to shorten the attack of toms as well. Now, most of you out there who are, I would say, enthusiastic amateurs all the way up to professionals probably have Trigger already. Most people have Trigger in their arsenal. And not a lot of people I see use this feature. They use it purely for sample replacement. But the gate feature, the Trigger's gate, is the best one I've ever used. I've got the Sonox drum gate. I've got gates for days. Nothing beats Trigger. It's incredible. Because it's designed, the algorithm or whatever, the coding in it is designed to replace drums, it's very, very good at listening for drum hits, which means the gate is also incredibly effective at listening for drum hits. It basically does exactly what Silencer does. So, TLDR. I'm going to include a preset down below in the description of a starting point for the Trigger gate settings that you can use on your projects. So, load the preset in and bam. Simple as that. Good to get you going. However, if you don't own Trigger and you have no intention on drum replacing, then Silencer is probably a good option for you, because let's just have another quick listen. If we turn Trigger off and then we put Silencer in, yeah, it's pretty good at what it does. But we put Trigger back on. Basically sounds identical. So truthfully, if you've got Trigger, I really wouldn't waste your money on this. It's not doing anything that you can't already do, as fancy as the interface is. If you don't have Trigger, it's a great option for you. That's my TLDR, Black Salt Audio Silencer. Should you buy it? Maybe. Probably not. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you again in the next video. Ciao for now.